Good day everyone, my name is Aisyah from the France Department of Universitas Indonesia and I'll be presenting my research entitled La Locolom and its impacts on the Sans-Papiers, which I wrote together with my corresponding author, Mrs. Irene Miranda. Immigration problems such as marginalization, negative sentiment towards immigrant, failure of integration, and the fear of losing national identity have not been resolved until Macron administration. France also had to deal with a surge in the number of sans-papiers or undocumented immigrants after the refugee crisis in 2015. To solve various problems, Macron administration finally passed a new immigration policy called La Locolom or Colom Law in September 2018. This research focuses on finding La Locolom plans to address immigration problem and how it affects the sans-papiers. It was written with Kressel qualitative method and Goshak historical approach to analyze various issues regarding French immigration. Foucault critical discourse analysis is also used to reveal the dialectic between policy as written and enacted. La Locolom has two main concepts, humanity and security. It divided into 5 parts and has 72 articles. This policy modifies several regulations and also maintains some the old ones. The duration of document checking has been increased from 16 to 24 hours to check the residence permit of each immigrant, thus preventing the possibility of dangerous immigrants around the street. This regulation proved that France still stigmatized immigrants as a potential criminal. For detention of immigrants, the Colom Law extends the maximum duration of detention at Centre de la Rétention Administrative or Immigrants Detention Center to 90 days in order to facilitate the process of deporting the sans-papiers. This new regulation shows that France is not siding with the sans-papiers because it only focuses on forced deportation. Colom Law also still permits the detention of minors with several terms. If the authorities detain their parent, then the child must go with the parents. Although it is meant to avoid separating children from their parents, it makes many children lose their freedom just because of their parent status. For immigrant screening, Colom Law maintains the screening of immigrants based on profession, educational background, and country of origin. Immigrants from safe countries will be automatically placed in a short document checking procedure. This policy generalizes immigrants from safe countries as a less qualified group for asylum. France also conducts a screening to determine the status of underage immigrants, one of which is examining bone maturity. This maturity evaluation puts immigrant minor as a target of suspicion. For integration program, La Locolom doubling France and citizenship training. This training is also including topics about professional work. For family reunification, this policy allows children to bring along their sibling, not only the parents. How does this policy affect the sans-papiers? After the ratification of La Locolom, not only doubling the maximum duration of detention to 90 days, but France is also trying to improve the condition of the detention center by adding more detention rooms so that detention center can accommodate more immigrants. The dialectic can be seen in this part. The policy doubled the duration of detention, but in its implementation, the authorities often detain the immigrants without considering their psychological condition. This policy also states that France plans to improve the condition of detention center. Still, the improvement is only focused on increasing the number of rooms, and France has no effort to enhance the quality of psychiatric service. La Locolom, both written and enacted, only intimidate the sans-papiers to the point of affecting their psychological state. The threat of deportation always haunts them, and it worsens their mental health. After the ratification of La Locolom, the undocumented immigrants became convinced that it will be easier for France to deport them. Because of that, some of them attempt suicide and rioted. La Locolom also dehumanizes underage immigrants. In 2019, at least 279 minors has been taken into custody with their parents, and the other 234 are minors without parents. Infomigrong reported that one of three children in detention center are children aged 2 to 6 years, and about 16 4.4% are children under 2 years old. Meanwhile, according to the data from Manabe, there were 154 children detained in Zone Datong in the first quarter of 2019. Child detention in detention center or Zone Datong deprived the right of freedom and health care. This policy also threatens children's mental health by allowing them to be in place full of violence. Lower column also allows the examination of bone maturity that is considered inaccurate. If the result say they were old enough, they would lose it from the government. They can end up in the streets and prisons and lose access to education and housing. In 2019, there were 260 minors at risk of losing aid from the government because the results show they were unadults. This policy also puts children in the possibility of deportation because they are considered mature enough to be returned to their country. It can be said that this policy deprives the rights of underage migrants. As a response to the notification of Lala Kolam, more than 1,500 sembahyang or local believer has initially marched, protested and demand their right to obtain an official residence permit, the right to obtain sufficient housing, and the right not to be deported. They criticized Kolam Law for facilitating the deportation process and making it more difficult for immigrants to obtain residence permits. According to the Legislative Noir, this policy forces immigrants to live with the status of sans-papier. In the end, ratification of the Law Kolam shows France relies on the deportation aspect to solve its problem. France never tried to improve their immigration system to make it easier for the sans-papier to obtain a residence permit and their right to freedom, health care, housing, and not be deported. This policy clearly shows that there is still France's rejection of immigrant existence. Macron's political spectrum differences with previous presidents have not changed the situation for immigrants. With that, concluding the presentation for today. This research is far from perfect, but I hope it can help evaluate the future immigration policy that is humanist and pro-immigrant.